Today, we're going to continue our discussion about unemployment. We're going to talk about one of my favorite days of the month. Usually on a Thursday night, I can't get to sleep in anticipation for this Friday. One of my favorite days of the month is Jobs Friday. Jobs Friday is the first Friday of every month. It's when the Bureau of Labor Statistics announces the unemployment rate for the previous month.
It's Jobs Day, giving us a look at it.
The BLS is responsible for making sure the unemployment rate is accurately reported, reported consistently, and reported frequently. Understanding what happens in labor markets allows us to have a better idea of what's happening in the overall economy. During the month, the BLS samples 60,000 households in 2,000 different geographic regions. These households are made up of roughly 110,000 individuals. Every month, the BLS replaces a quarter of the households, and no household can be in the data more than 4 consecutive months. Based on the answers of the survey, the BLS estimates the total number of people unemployed in the US and what the unemployment rate is. Then using this information, the BLS calculates several measures of unemployment. The most popular one that is tracked is the U3 unemployment rate. Economists actually track several measures of unemployment.
And that's how the unemployment data is collected. The BLS uses this data to separate people into different categories.
The total US population is roughly 330 million people. First important definition is the working age population. It includes civilians above the age of 15 that are not institutionalized. The military is excluded from unemployment and labor force calculations. That group is then split into the labor force and not in the labor force. Not in the labor force is defined as students, homemakers, retirees, discouraged workers. The labor force is then split into two different groups, those that are employed and those that are unemployed. Using this information, we can then calculate the unemployment rate. By dividing the unemployed by the labor force and multiplying it by 100. This is how the U3 calculation of unemployment rate is done. A 30-year graph of the U3 unemployment rate looks like this. As I mentioned, the U3 unemployment rate is the most popular measure of unemployment, and it is the one that is usually referenced in the news.
After 2 months of unprecedented increases, U.S. unemployment rate took a surprising turn in May. It went down. This dip was a hopeful sign that the economy might be bouncing back from coronavirus lockdowns. But that dip wasn't universal. Black unemployment ticked upwards. It declined in June, but not at the same rate as unemployment overall. This follows a decade where the unemployment gap between white and black workers has been narrowing. But the recent unemployment figures reveal the financial fragility.
There are other unemployment rates that we also keep track of. The BLS reports U1 through U6 every month. Each measure helps us learn more about the different segments of the labor market. Another measure that the BLS provides is the labor force participation rate. It measures the labor force as a fraction of working age population. And it is measured by dividing the labor force by the working age population and then multiplying it by 100. The past 30 years of data shows us that the labor force participation rate hovers around 63%. During recessions, the labor force participation rate falls as more people exit the labor market and shift towards education or other activities that are not in the labor market. The labor force participation rate is also sensitive to the population pyramid. In countries where the population is aging, the labor force participation rate will be lower. As people retire, they exit the labor force.
Now you know more about unemployment. More importantly, you know about my favorite day of the month, Jobs Friday.